And we back! Y'all, it is time for the first official rebuilding challenge of NBA 2K21 Next Gen. My NBA! The first one ever on this channel. I must admit, I'm a little bit nervous because I need to start off strong and let's go one for one in today's video. Now, the original idea was to come in, bring another basketball team to Seattle, and have them win a championship. Well, we ran into our very first bug of Next Gen 2K, because if you load in an expansion team right now, the game just automatically crashes 100% of the time. So instead, until 2K can fix that, we're going to be rebuilding current NBA teams, and we're starting off with the Lakers. Now you're looking at me like, Kenny, the Lakers literally just won a championship. What type of rebuild can they need? Well, they probably want to try to repeat, and I'm here to help them repeat, and not only just that. We trying to hit the three-peat for the Los Angeles Lakers in today's video. They already got one, and I need two and three. Before we get into it, I got to remind you that this is a hub of NBA 2K21 content, and that sounds like something you're interested in. Be sure to subscribe. We're on the road to a million. I can't get that if you don't subscribe. And the last thing is to leave a like on the video. We got another 2K21 video dropping later tonight as well, so be looking out for that. Two videos one day, yes, sir. It is important time in the 2K realm, and I must be prepared. Now, let's go rebuild the Los Angeles Lakers. I can't even believe I'm saying that right now. Now, again, obviously, the Lakers have a recipe that worked very well. They already won a championship, but the biggest question with them is the longevity of it all. Because if we take a look at this roster, we're going to have two of the best players in the league. Then after that, there's a drop-off with the overall. We have Dwight Howard, that's really a 78. Rondo, JaVale McGee, Danny Green, these were all quality players for them. But the problem is they're all old at this point. So my job is to come in, get a little bit of youth in here, get a little bit more well-rounded talent, maybe try to get a third star. I ain't saying he's going to be an all-star, but get a third real, like, really good option. Because we got teams that's getting better. You know what I'm saying? So it's not going to be a cakewalk for the Lakers, man. So I need to make it as easy as possible. And that's with me being the general manager and making trades. Now, the first trade we're going to do is a trade that's actually rumored to happen in real life, potentially. And that is Derrick Rose getting to LA. I love Derrick Rose, and I need him on the team trying to compete for a championship. Now, the last time Derrick Rose, LeBron James played on the same team, it did not go well whatsoever. But things are different now. I'm going to make this trade. Danny Green and Kyle Kuzma are going to Detroit, and we're getting back Langston Galloway and Derrick Rose. And Langston Galloway, low-key, kind of an underrated player in the trade. He may come in and score some buckets. So that is our trade. Now, is that star number three? It might be. I mean, we don't have a lot of wiggle room in the cap flexibility, and we don't have a lot of wiggle room when it comes to the picks, because we gave up a lot of picks to bring in the unibrow. At the end of the day, you don't regret it because the unibrow got you a championship or helped you get a championship. But we are working with limited assets right now. So this job is a little bit tougher than it may seem on the surface. Now, we can argue all day on whether or not Anthony Davis should actually be running center, but he don't really want to. So since he don't want to, I will make him do it. I'm going to trade for Clint Capella and a first round pick that is 2.5-star value. Now, that first round pick will be dealt again, and we're going to get something real special for that. But as of right now, our point guard is Derrick Rose, and our center is Clint Capella, which is a W. Now, the only player on the only three players on this roster that are untouchable is, of course, LeBron and Anthony Davis and Alex Caruso. Everybody else could go. I love what Rondo gave us in the playoffs and everything, but in real life, he's rumored to not even want to resign. He may go somewhere else and get a bag. So, you know, I don't feel no attachment to him as much as we have an attachment to the GOAT Alex Caruso. But everybody else could go, you know, and we got that first round pick. Let's go get us a nice two-way wing defender, because as of right now, Alex Caruso will be starting for us, which is all right, but I'd rather him just come off the bench. Of course, we got LeBron, and then we got Anthony Davis and Clint Capella, and right now, Dwight is on the team, and I'm cool with Dwight being a backup right now. He played that role pretty well. So let's find that shooting guard for this starting lineup. All right, with the value of this pick, I'm thinking, man, I think we could get something pretty special. So I need to find a team that is selling or rebuilding and try to get their shooting guard. That's the way I'm looking at it. I'm going to go talk to the Pacers about disgruntled ex-star Victor Oladipo. He's making $21 million. I'm willing to throw in Clint Capella in this deal because I think the center position is one that we would be cool if we don't have a very good center, because we have Anthony Davis and we would still have Dwight Howard. Obviously, they would accept this trade. Okay, I was going to say they weren't going to accept it, but they both wore 82 overall, so I guess that's all that really mattered at the end of the day. So maybe that third star is Victor Oladipo in Los Angeles. Is that a W? We will find out. So at the current look of our team is Derrick Rose, Victor Oladipo, LeBron James, Anthony Davis, and Dwight Howard. And off the bench, well, the bench could still use some help. Now, the best thing about that is I was going into that thinking that I was going to have to throw in the first round pick. We still have one first round pick that we can use to increase our bench depth, because right now that is kind of lacking. And I think we answer the bench depth question by bringing in Seth Curry. You know, we get shooters around here, and Willie Cauley-Stein to be a backup center. And just like that, I think we turned this team around a little bit. Again, this was a team that just won a championship, and I might be crazy for breaking it all up, but I would say this team looks better on paper than the last year's Lakers, and we need that. You know, we even still got Caruso getting minutes. That's a W. It's a W if you ask me. Now, the next thing is just to simulate a little bit to see, oh, first game of the season did not go our way, but that's okay. It's the first game of the season. Second game of the season against the Bulls, that's more like it. Whew. We had four players put up 20-plus points. Victor Oladipo, Derrick Rose, Anthony Davis, and LeBron James all have great games for us. Seth Curry off the bench put up 16, only shot the ball. That's the only thing we need from you. Only thing we need. And then Dwight Howard putting up good numbers. Now, the way I'm thinking about it is, Dwight is good. But is he our best option here? Now, he's only making $1 million, and that's like super, super plus. Avery Bradley is not getting minutes for us anymore, right? Avery Bradley's not getting minutes for us anymore. We throw him and Dwight together with this second that we have. We didn't get any better options. So we're just going to roll with it for now. Again, the center position is not one we need somebody to be really, really good, because you have Anthony Davis who's going to run some center. And we're starting off the season just maybe a little bit slower than expected. But it's all right. We are not doing this trade though. Season is wrapped and LeBron got the MVP award in year, I think technically this is year number 18. He gets the MVP award, averaging 25, 11, and about 9 rebounds, a steal, a block, 50% from the field. His best 3-point percentage of his NBA career. Beautiful. Now, in real life, I don't know who the heck this guy is. In real life, this team breezed through the playoffs, only losing a few games. And I'm trying to mimic that today. We got Coach Frank Vogel as the coach of the year. And whoever, oh, I think this is us. This is us, right? We have a 99 offense, a 99 defense, and a 99 overall. And I think this is supposed to be us, because same. I don't know why they won't let us put our face scan. If we're going to be the executive, let me put my face scan in these videos. So LeBron, of course, All-NBA first team because he was the MVP. We have Anthony Davis on the second team, of course, putting up 26, 14. Great numbers, 2.5 blocks. And that's all she really wrote. You know, we ready to go out there and potentially win this championship. We're going against Portland again in the first round. You know, they didn't make a single change to the roster. Looks like same exact team, but Rodney Hood is back from his injury. So first game we win. Second game we win. Third, okay, we're going for a sweep. And we get the sweep done. Cool. Second round, we're going against the Pelicans. Uh-oh, a little revenge. Anthony Davis can get revenge against the Pelicans, and then Lonzo and Brandon Ingram could potentially get revenge against the Lakers. Now, I'm saying, I'm going to go out on a limb and say my team will win because it's my team, but who really knows? Game one is a win, and a game where LeBron put up 35, 12, 11, and 4 steals. Derrick Rose having great playoff moments. It's exactly what I traded for him for. I need my boy to be on a contending team, and just like that, we're in the conference finals to go against our biggest rival. And probably our biggest matchup, this LA Clippers team, who have not made any trades or anything except for Lou Williams is now a starter and not coming off the bench. Let's see. Game one is a Lakers. We won by 40. 40. That's a statement game if I've ever seen one. Oh, they come back and win by 5, but we ain't worried about that. We had our statement game, and that's all it really meant. Another 150-plus game for us. When this team is supposed to be elite defenders, I couldn't tell. They're getting spanked. 3-1 us, and we get a good old-fashioned rematch, Lakers versus Heat. Oh, you can't make this up. You cannot make this up, and they have the same exact team as well. All right, can we repeat, or will the Miami Heat get their revenge? It don't look like they will, because we're not going to blow a 3-0 lead, and just like that, another ring is there for the Lakers, and this time, Anthony Davis gets the Finals MVP. Averaging about 29 points per game, 16 rebounds, 2 assists, and 3 blocks. Now, I promise y'all the goal was to win 2 more championships, and 1 is done. And now we're about to go into the hardest part of the video. And the reason why, because as I mentioned, Anthony Davis is a free agent. I guess technically LeBron James is a free agent too, because he didn't want to sign his extension. So we have our two best players as free agents, and our goal right now is to retain them. Actually, we got our top four players as free agents. But of course, we're prioritizing these top two dudes because we don't win without them. We don't have a pick in this year's draft, of course, because we threw them all away. But that's fine. We got two championships in a row. Who cares about first round picks when you got two championships? And LeBron declined his player option, which is the scariest thing I've ever said. If LeBron does not come back into the team, well, we're going to be in a tough spot. Kostas Antetokounmpo is not going to be able to save us. And actually, you can walk a free agency 64 overall. So LeBron already has 10 offers, and the Raptors and the Bulls and the Grizzlies are at the top of his list. But I'm guessing if I threw LeBron at 36 years old, a max contract, and a no-trade clause, and a player option, he's going to prioritize that, because why wouldn't he? Listen, you're looking at me like, Kenny, you're going to be paying a 40-year-old LeBron James $30-plus million? No, I won't. I'm not going to be making this video in 3 years. We only got one more year to repeat. I don't care about after that. Anthony Davis, the Hawks gave him a pretty big contract, pretty nice contract, but guess what? We can offer this man the Supermax, and I'm throwing that same thing. Player option, no trade clause, and both of them are back. Beautiful. Now, the next thing is we have to build a budget team because we have not a lot of money and literally only three players on our roster. We have LeBron, we have Anthony Davis, and we have Seth Curry. That's it. That's all. So we have to put together a budget team to put around those guys. As much as I would like to bring Victor Oladipo back, he would cost way too much money. It looks like the Atlanta Hawks gave him a bag, so shout out to him for that. We need to get, like, budget options. Now, we'll be rough, but I'm the general manager, and I know how to work these things. So the players we brought in for impact players, Bogey, Monte Morris, Rashawn Holmes, Seth Curry still on the roster. We brought in old Justin Holiday, who hasn't got worse. We bring in Damian Lee, Raul Nato, just a bunch of roster for the guys that don't really matter. But again, my goal is to win another championship. So yes, we're about to be moving some pieces here and there to increase the ceiling of this team. And the genie is about to work his magic. Zach LaVine is that third star. They want Raul Nato. They'll give us back Daniel Gafford. We have a deal. And I did just give up a bunch of pieces on our team, but you cannot mess with star power, and Zach LaVine adds that. Right now, our starting point guard is non-existent, but we will make that fix. I think that was a W of a trade. I think it was. You know, it don't get better. And we get the backup at Daniel Gafford. We have another scoring option for Anthony Davis and LeBron to play with. All right, it's time for me to work my real magic. I'm bringing in Taco Fall and getting the first round pick in exchange. All right, I had to trade Damian Lee, but we already had two point or shooting guard, so I didn't really need a third one, so that's done. We're still looking for this point guard, and now we have two extra first round picks to potentially pair with somebody, and Jalen Brunson could come in and play that role perfectly. I mean, you got LeBron James, who's literally gonna really be your point guard, so you don't really need that much point guard depth. We have Jalen Brunson, we have Zach LaVine, LeBron, Anthony Davis, and Rashawn Holmes. Off the bench, we have Seth Curry, Daniel Gafford, Justin Holiday, Georges Niang getting some PT. I don't really love that too much, so let's see if there's one more trade we can do. There's not another trade to do, but I'm going to simulate to see how things start off, and then we'll determine if we need to make a trade. But we're starting off the season 4-1, 5-1. This feels like a repeat type of team to me. Our two main pieces are the same. Everything else has changed. This is going to be a three-peat, potentially, where the team looks different every single season, except for the top two guys, just showing the excellence of LeBron and the excellence of Anthony Davis. Now, I think last year we only had 16 losses, so this year we are better. Luka wins MVP with a 36-point triple-double. Jermaine Barnes. Luka had DeMarcus and Kristaps on his team. That's a team we need to be worried about, for real. Zion Nye's Defensive Player of the Year. Ja Morant wins Most Improved. And then, of course, Frank Vogel goes back-to-back, and I will go back-to-back. I guess I'm Adrian Mills in today's video, going back-to-back as Executive of the Year. Anthony Davis makes All-NBA First Team. LeBron does not. Oh, you see his morale? He's really happy, and he trusts us a little bit. Oh, Giannis morale, not very good. Oh, you went to OKC, huh, Giannis? I did not see that coming, and that's why he's upset, I guess. Kyrie morale is never going to be good. Why is nobody happy except for Anthony Davis is ecstatic? You know what I'm saying? He's super happy about things, and nobody else is. Everybody's just stale-faced across the league, except for my top two players, baby. We're doing something great in LA where everybody's happy to play here, and nobody else is happy anywhere else in the league. Like, literally, the only players to smile is our players. Oh, wow. That's actually insane. Everybody says they're satisfied. I'm fine. I'm feeling okay. I'm feeling content. But Anthony Davis is, I'm thrilled. Let's get it. Let's run it back. I don't understand. I feel like I want to go through the entire league and see who's happy and who's not. For reference, everybody on my team is extremely happy. If I go over to the Magic, not a single player is happy. If I go over to... Uh-oh. No. I think it crashed. It crashed. I'll be back. I'm going to try it again. But yeah, it just seems like nobody's happy except for the LA Lakers players in the entire league. So we're doing something right in LA, and maybe that's going to be the determining factor for us to go three-peating. The first team we're going against in this round is D'Angelo Russell, Karl-Anthony Towns, Minnesota Timberwolves. I don't feel too nothing. Hold on. They came out strong, didn't they? Hold on. We're not about to not do that. We're not doing that tonight. We're going for our repeat. 2-2, 3-2 us. They scared us a little bit, but we came out. We fought hard, and now we're going against Giannis and the OKC Thunder, who have a nice... This is a good team. Giannis, Shea... Some auto-generated 78 overall that LeBron is going to feast on. Giannis and then Hassan Whiteside. That is a good team. It is. We win game one. We win game two. I guess it wasn't better than the Minnesota team who took two for us. I don't understand it. But now we have another rematch from last season. But now instead of Lonzo Ball, they got Frederick Van Vliet. And then Zion is a 93 overall. Brandon Ingram is pretty high overall as well. Game one is a Laker game. Game two is a Laker game. Game three is a Laker game. And we sweep them to get to the championship to go against the Celtics. Another classic rivalry. Did they make any changes to their team? Robert Williams is a starting center. But other than that, this is the exact same roster. Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown are both 90-plus overalls. Can we pull it off? We lose game one. I'm okay with that. I'm not okay with losing two in a row, though. Okay, fight. Okay, fight, Lakers. Back against the wall, championship again for LeBron James, but Anthony Davis takes finals MVP, and that's it. It's a wrap. We completed the Lakers three-peat. How'd I do? The first official rebuild of NBA 2K21 Next Gen is in the books, and we got two championships in 2 years. Shout out to Lakers Nation, man. Let me know what other teams you want to see me do in the future or another rebuilding challenge you want to see me attack. Of course, I'm accepting them all in Next Gen. Thank y'all so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Oh, I'll see you later today. Peace.